Very good afternoon, children. As we have discussed about the advancing monsoon, the rest of the students who could not listen properly or they are not connected to the online, they will also be benefited from this explanation. Let's get started. This season starts in the month of June and continues till the end of September. What is that? Advancing monsoon. It starts from the month of June up to the September. Due to excessive heating of land during the summer season, a low pressure area develops over northwest India. The southeast trade winds are attracted towards this region. These winds living from the Indian Ocean cross the equator and pass over the Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal. Means the wind blows from south in southeast part of the country, that is the trade winds, that is attracted towards this region, and these wind living from the Indian Ocean cross the equator and pass over the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal. अरबियन सी से लेकर के बे ऑफ बंगाल तक ये पास करती है और दीज विंड्स ब्लो एज साउथ वेस्ट मानसूनस और द समर मानसूनस. द बल्क ऑफ रेनफॉल इन मैनी पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया इज ड्यू टू दीज विंड्स. मैनी पार्ट्स ऑफ द इंडिया दे गेट रेनफॉल ड्यू टू दीज विंड्स. These blow in the months of June to September. ये trade wind जो है June से September के बीच में ये चलती है. The amount decreases from south to north and east to west. इसका amount धीरे धीरे घटते जाता है कहाँ से? South to north and east to west. However, the Tamil Nadu coast remains dry at this time. There is no rainfall in Tamil Nadu region, that is remain dry this time. The direction of southwest monsoon winds is determined by the relief features of our country. The Indian Peninsula divides these winds into the Arabian Sea branch and the Bay of Bengal branch. The Arabian Sea branch strikes the western coast of India and moves from the Malabar coast towards the north. The Bay of Bengal branch strikes the Bengal coast and the southern part of Meghalaya. Here the monsoon winds are deflected and move westward along the Ganga plain and parallel to the Himalayan mountain ranges. The sudden advent of monsoon winds along with thunder or lightning is called the burst of monsoon. The southwest monsoon winds reach India by the start of June. This is known as the onset of monsoon. Gradually, within 4 to 5 weeks, both the branches of the monsoon winds overrun almost the whole country. Means it acquire whole part of the country. After a few weeks, after 4 or 5 weeks, that is known as the onset of monsoon. Post or retreating monsoon. Post or retreating monsoon kya hai? The retreat of the monsoon winds starts in the second week of September. The withdrawal begins from the northwestern plains of India and finally leaves the Ganga Delta by the middle of October. The months of October and November are marked by clear skies and warm days but cooler evenings. The weather is oppressive at times and is commonly called the October heat. By December, the temperature goes down to mark the onset of winter season. These 2 months mark a period of transition between the hot wet season and the cold dry season. The cyclones originating over the Bay of Bengal reach the eastern coast of India and cause widespread damage to life and property in the thickly populated deltas of the Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri rivers. A long dry spell reduces the possibility of a bumper crop, thus disturbing the economic life. The monsoons at the right time bring a welcome relief not only to farmers but also to the city dwellers. The annual cycle of season is dominated by the monsoons. All forms of life, plants, animals, and human beings in India respond to the seasonal rhythms created by the monsoons. Nature of monsoon. Following are some of the characteristics features of monsoons in India. That is, they are seasonal in nature. The winds are uncertain and irregular in their approach as well as rate. Rainfall is unequally distributed over the country. Some areas have a water surplus while others remain dry. Number 4, monsoon rainfall is also unequally spread over the year. The 3/4 of the rainfall is concentrated from June to September, whereas most of the country remains dry in winter. Distribution of rainfall. The rainfall in India is not evenly distributed. It is mainly attributed to the relief features of the land and direction of the wind. The distribution can be divided into 4 main categories as follows. Number 1, regions under very heavy rainfall, regions under heavy rainfall. Regions under moderate rainfall, regions under low rainfall. These are 4 categories of rainfall. Regions under very heavy rainfall. Which are the regions? They come under the heavy rainfall areas. The western coastal areas and slopes of the western ghats get very heavy rainfall from the southwest monsoon of the Arabian Sea branch, while the eastern slopes of the western ghats lie in the rain shadow areas. In the northern plains, the rainfall decreases from east to west as the Bay of Bengal branch of the southwest monsoon sheds its moisture all along up the Ganga Valley. This branch of southwest monsoon gets deflected by the Arakan Mountains of Myanmar and then moves up the Ganga Plains. A sub-branch of the same Bay of Bengal, southwest monsoon moves east and gets trapped in the mountains and enters the Brahmaputra Valley. At this point, it is forced to rise suddenly through a tunnel-shaped valley near the Khasi Hill, where heavy rains occur. In short, the monsoon originating from the Bay of Bengal is blocked by the Khasi Jaintia Hills and then East Himalayan ranges cause heavy rainfall in northeast India. In this way, Mysingram near Cherrapunji in Meghalaya on the windward side of the northeastern hills gets one of the highest rainfall in the world, recording about 10.42 centimeter in a year. Very heavy rainfall is there in Mysingram. However, Shillong in the neighborhood gets only 200 centimeter of rain. Regions under heavy rainfall. The areas that receive 100 to 200 centimeter of rainfall come under the category the southeastern coast of India receives a moderate amount of rainfall during the winter season from the northeast monsoon and radiating southwest monsoon. Again, the amount of rain decreases with monsoonal movement from the south to the north and east to west. Regions under moderate rainfall. The areas that receive 50 to 100 centimeter of rainfall under this category. These areas include Gujarat, Eastern Rajasthan, Western Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, Northern Punjab, and most of the Deccan surrounded by hills on all the sides. Parts of West Bengal, Eastern Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, and Punjab receive moderate rainfall from the Bay of Bengal monsoon branch. Odisha and Madhya Pradesh are also included under the regions receiving moderate rainfalls. So next we shall discuss in the next video. Till then, thank you guys.